know. Carolyn, hello there.
So nice to see you, Mr. President.
Well, it's so nice of you to come down. Let me say happy anniversary.
Oh, listen, this will, we'll never forget this one.
Well, let me say happy anniversary.
Absolutely.
We picked a good day for this.
Yes, sir, we sure did.
Smart people get married on March the 4th.
Yeah, yes. As a matter of fact, Nancy, a little tip for you in case he's ever beginning to get forgetful or anything. Nancy figured it out once, so I could never slip up on a date.
Oh, my. Put it on the calendar, isn't that, oh, isn't that clever? Oh, my. That really is something. We wanted to give you a little something from not only us, Mr. President, but all of Kentucky. There's a lot of love that goes into this little simple token. I suppose that one might say, I guess I could say from one state to another, but maybe I better not say that. This is a shoe of Secretariat.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
That was worn by him.
Wow.
That Secretary is now in our district in Kentucky.
He's known pretty well across the country, yes.
People at home obviously are very pleased to be able to have us.
This is very nice of you. Thank you very much.
A lot of good luck with that.
Yep, yes, sir. And maybe a lot of people don't know that after they win a race, they take those off.
Well, that's right. That's exactly right. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. I used to raise racehorses, but I never raised any as good as him.
Well, that's a very special horse. We're very pleased to have it in our district, of course. Pleased to present that to you.
Thank you very much.
Have a nice day.
Well, I sure will. Being in this business myself, I know what you and Nancy mean to others like us and what you have to put up with.
Thank you.
We're just better off for all that you do for us.
We enjoy it.
You know, I must tell you that I watch you when you come down to the House floor. And I think it's a real nice touch that every time, before you start, I notice that you look up there and wink at Nancy. And that's a nice touch. That's a very thoughtful thing. We appreciate your being where you are and the kind of guy you are. This country's so proud of you. And to hear that so many times, I don't mean to be redundant, but it is so true. We're comfortable with you.
Thank you very much.
Yes, sir.
And again, this isn't exactly where it's bound this happy.
No.
It's a good start.
Thank you, sir. Good luck to you. Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
64 years between us.
That's right. Thank you.
Priorities, priorities.
Preceding.
One of the reasons for this is there are many significant world events that have taken place over the past several weeks. We witnessed a peaceful transfer of power in the Philippines and Haiti, and an assassination in Sweden. And the 27th Communist Party Congress has been meeting in Moscow. In addition, we've begun the congressional effort to further assist the democratic resistance in Nicaragua. And we've taken the offensive on obtaining adequate funds for our defense. And now, George, you called on Secretary Schultz, and he's going to start off by giving us a briefing on the current world situation. We think that some of these things we've been so immersed in, we haven't had time to bring you all up to date and leave you alone.
Thank you, Mr. President. As your opening comment suggested, we see a pattern around the world of tragedy and triumph. And you can make that statement practically at any moment. You mentioned the assassination of the Prime Minister of Sweden. We also had the assassination of a very courageous man who had accepted to be mayor of Nablus on the West Bank. And the enemies of peace and the enemies of things that are constructive in that region murdered him. And so it's always so that you have those threats. At the same time, we've all watched and taken part in the events in the Philippines, and there we see very clearly the triumph of the will for freedom and democracy. And we also see what is less noticed, although I think that the president has gotten a considerable amount of credit for it. Less noticed is that we have had a consistent policy for a long period of time in the Philippines. We know a lot about it. And within the framework of the strategy we've had and the knowledge we've had as events were unfolding, it was possible to make tactical decisions that worked out. And we had considerable credit.
Yes.
See you.
President Les Aspin, how are you, sir? Nice to see you. How are you?
Hi, President.
Good to see you.
Yeah.
Mr. President, Donnie Fasel.
Yes.
How are you? Nice to see you.
Excuse me.
The White House,
President. Wonderful to see you again.
Johnny Wick, how you doing?
I'm the same way. I'm sorry. You'll see this. Donnie Fasel. Donnie, how are you?
Donnie,
well, Chief Secretary.
I see you worn off the right
Vice President's chair.
Honey, all that Jamie Wick, the man is going to provide the money. So
I know our time is limited here, and I just got a little tired here of a note that they just received that I think should be an important part of this discussion. It's a development that came about yesterday that Duarte has announced that if the Sandinistas have talked with their armed opposition, he will talk with the Salvadoran guerrillas. Same basis, lay down the arms, amnesty, come in and talk. And this opens the possibility of three sets of talks because we have already said that we will meet with the Sandinistas, in spite of the fact that we've done it 9 times already without but too much result, if they'll meet simultaneously with the armed opposition. And this shows, I think, a negotiated solution is possible. We have some momentum going for us, and I think the key is for the Sandinista to agree to talk with their opposition, and we need to get that message to your colleagues there in the Hill.
Good to present our strawberry queen.
Well,
Kathy
it's
Jo
my pleasure
Rex
to receive
Road.
You. Well, congratulations to you.
Thank you very much. It's a privilege to meet you.
Well, this is a very nice thing the Senator does every year.
Yes, it is.
Bring me a strawberry queen. Well,
thank you. Thank you. Mr. Fiola,
the president of the Strawberry Festival, and we brought you a gift from West Virginia Principal. I'd like to give you an honor of this visitation.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Mrs. Fiola and daughter Heather.
Heather,
nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you. Hello, Heather.
Nice to
see you.
These are
thank you very much. Thank you.
This is the Queen's mother and father, Mrs. Rex Rowe.
Hello. Hello there.
My name is Carol.
Well,
and this is for you from Kathy Jo, which I had the honor of making for you.
Yeah, I see. I don't have to tear the things off. I see I can open it and look. Oh.
That's for you to curl up and keep warm. Well,
that's wonderful. And it's a flag.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Redford.
Hello there. Nice to see you.
This is a gift I have for you, Mrs. Reagan. It's a handmade ceramic of strawberry.
Thank you. I'll be very happy though to take it on the day after our 34th anniversary.
Yes, congratulations. Our citizen is last night.
Mr. President, I'm on my way to our 49th anniversary. Herman. I was a child, right?
I started a little late. Well, this is very nice of you to bring it. And why don't you come over here? And we got first we get a we get this, and then we get a group picture.
Okay.
Thanks.
Now, well, why don't you all gather around? I'm going to stay
here. Okay.
So, yeah, I'm going to sign that over here.
May I lay these down in the chair?
Pete, you want to?
Yeah, let's get one more on this side, Bass.
Somebody want to jump on that?
Come on, Heather.
One more. Thank you, sir.
Well, it was very nice.
Thank you, Mr. Pat.
Very nice of you to see us.
Thank you.
It's been an honor.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you for my presence.
And we are very honored. Thank you. I don't have a frame for this, but this is one of my autographing pictures.
Well, thank you.
I should have brought a frame, but I was kind of rushed.
I'll take care of that. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Now, yeah, they say family. Once again, it's just his daughter, his son-in-law, his granddaughter.
Yeah, and the...
Of course, his wife was killed in a car accident a couple of years ago.
I don't think I'll say...
No, because they're not all from Utah. They're spread out all over the country now.
Yeah. And they're just coming to meet you.
Sure, just for a phone.
President, how are you?
Fine, thank you. I'd like you to meet my daughter Sue again.
Hi.
Granddaughter Allison and my son-in-law, Dr. Alan Moore.
And the newest addition to the family.
No, the second newest. We had three grandchildren, all within 5 months last year. I had two children graduate from college. Space flight, three grandchildren, all in 5 months last year. Your speech about Paul was just magnificent the other night. I cried a little bit, so. Well, let's...
Why don't you all get in here?
Yeah, let me get...
Family picture.
Why don't you get in the middle, Susan?
Okay. Where? Here?
Yeah.
And now she'll see the cameras.
Look right here. Thank you.
Never seen it to fail, and just tune us out. That's all she sees.
Well, thank you.
Thank you very much.
We were scheduled to do this last year, and Allison came early, and so we didn't get to do it. It's better because she wouldn't have been in the picture.
Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Oh, did it?
So maybe we ought to.
I didn't hear that. West Virginia Crescent.
Maybe we ought to take a look at it.
I don't know if Russell likes those or not. He's pretty particular.
Oh.
The dog.
Yes. Well, we'll take those upstairs. Rex. Right?
I guess it's okay if the first dog eats something and the Secret Service hasn't checked.
Yeah. And it's sealed.
We'll do the presentations over here. It's just Orrin Hatch and you.
Hey, Orrin, how are you?
Good.
Good to see you. How's it going?
All right. I don't know.
We're working at you. We're working hard on that.
I know. It's great to see you.
I think we're supposed to go over there.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Sure Living Products have this done for you. Rex Mon used to be with Dell Wind Corporation. And then this is done specially for you by one of, I think, Utah's greatest artists, a young man named Crazy. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've been trying to get these to you. Aren't they beautiful? Well, I'll tell you what, I'll get you the names and addresses and we'll get it sent to them. We'll send them a copy of this picture.
All right.
Okay. That's good. Thanks, man.
Glad to be able to serve this to you.
Always nice to do something for you for a change.
Well, you get the addresses to me.
I will.
These pictures here.
Medicine, we're working on the kind of stuff today.
Working hard.
And also, I know we have 3 weeks in the meeting. That was just happened this morning.
I know. I can tell this guy. I think it was just happened.
Well, we can do it. I agree with you. If you have, we've got to let me away from that stuff.
I know what they're doing. I was trying to show hope.
Sorry. Thank you.
It's not the best one I've seen. They're not bringing the ground.
Oh, the ground dogs would be.
That's a big deal back there. Is that a big deal?
Place and photograph people going out to see who comes out at night.
Of course, in Southern California, you never have to worry about it being a short early springer or late springer. Anyhow, they are going to give you a coin.
Good morning, Mr. President.
Hi.
No player. Good to see you.
See you.
Appreciate you doing this, Mr. Al Anthony.
Nice to meet you,
Mr. President.
Nice to see you.
Jim Means.
Means President. Nice to see you.
No.
Hello there.
Happy to know you. Happy to see you.
That's punk to Donnie Phil.
Oh, we're back.
They would let us bring the live one, Mr. President.
Mr. President, on behalf of the Punxsutawney Chamber of Commerce, the Groundhog Club, and the citizens of the weather capital of the world, I'm honored to present you with that silver medallion commemorating Punxsy Phil's 100th anniversary.
Well, I'm very pleased and proud to have that. And if we put to rest that rumor that I was there at the first time around.
Mr. President, we couldn't bring His Majesty Punxsutawney Phil, so we decided to bring you his picture. He's got his paws on the back and signatures.
Well, there he is.
Thank you, sir.
Well.
Mr. President, you always look so fit and so wonderful, and you seem like you're on a diet. I don't know how much Nancy cooks, but what I'd like to do is give this to you to give to Nancy, which is a groundhog cookbook. And on page 126, it tells how to cook a groundhog, but that's kind of sacrilegious for us to eat our hero. So on behalf of the Chamber of Commerce and Mrs. Elaine Light, who wrote the book, we hope that Nancy will find some recipes in there to kind of fatten up.
Well, thank you very much. I'm very pleased to have that, and she will be too. And silver remembrance and the picture of His Majesty.
And we won't tell anyone that you were around when Phil first appeared.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Virginia.
We certainly are happy that we could come and visit you.
Thank you.
God bless you, Mr. President. Take care.
Thank you very much.